Thanks for logging on. Chris Widlic along with Dave Griffiths. Instant reaction to the Colts draft pick, round two, pick number 54. And we thought maybe tackle, maybe tight end, maybe cornerback. And they pulled a surprise. And Chris Ballard tends to do that, right?
Another defensive end, Dayo Odeyingbo out of Vanderbilt. Obviously, not a lot of college football fans watch Vanderbilt because they don't have a great team usually. They don't have a great season, but Dayo was a heck of a player. Really a stud on that team, a disruptor on the defensive line. They played him everywhere, Chris. They played him from the outside to the inside because he could disrupt anywhere. He's listed as a defensive end, so that makes two defensive ends now that the Colts have taken to start off this draft in rounds one and two.
A little bit bizarre, too, and this guy's coming off a torn Achilles. I don't think he'll be ready to hit the field until August, maybe play mid-season or so. So there's not a rush with this guy. I know Quiddy Pay is going to probably step right in without Houston gone now and Autry also out. So what happens the rest of the day? They don't have a pick in round three. Do you think they're going to be able to trade up, or are we going to let this thing slide into Saturday?
It would take a lot to get back into this round, I think. It would probably involve trading some of next year's picks, like maybe next year's third-round pick to get in, plus something else, whether it's something from this year or a player. But who knows? I'm not going to put it past Chris Ballard to trade up, because people always talk about him trading down. He does that a lot, but he's traded up a couple times as well, traded up notably to get safety Kari Willis a couple years ago, and he turned into a starter on the Colts defense. So if there's somebody that he wants, there, don't be surprised if he trades back in, but I'm certainly not beholden to that, as the Colts now don't have any picks for the remainder of tonight, at least.
Yeah, last thought. Chris Ballard told us earlier that there's not a lot of great tackles out there, not a lot of left tackles, yeah. And that's what he's looking for. Maybe they go to the free agent route at this point. To me, that's what it's going to look like.
And right now, there are some available free agents to tackle out there. Alejandro Villanueva, who was with the Steelers before, Russell Okung. Also, Eric Fisher, who also had an injury in the playoffs last year before the Chiefs made the Super Bowl. Still a free agent, only 30 years old, a former number one overall pick. History with Chris Ballard. An option, but again, as someone who wouldn't be ready for the start of the season, so you're going to have somebody play left tackle. Might be Sam Tevy, Julian Davenport, one of those players the Colts brought in as free agents already.
That's the question right now. That's Dave. I'm Chris. Thanks for logging on, and we'll probably see you again tomorrow.